Trump says he might record future meetings after made up comments about removing Haitians. On Friday, President Donald Trump seemed to threaten to record future Oval Office meetings after a report indicated he called for removing Haitians from the United States. Sources told the Washington Post on Thursday that while discussing temporary legal protection for Haitians, Trump asked, "Why do we need more Haitians?" and told those attending to take them out. "Never said take them out," Trump said, likely a way for him to say he never requested deportation for those receiving temporary legal protection. Although Trump may have not said that during his Thursday meeting, his administration, at the end of last year, effectively gave Haitians until July 2019 to either leave the United States or find protection under another immigration category. That resulted from the administration's decision to end a program providing temporary protected status for those nearly 60,000 Haitians impacted by the 2010 earthquake that hit their nation. During his meeting, Trump was also discussing protections for Salvadoran immigrants, a group whose temporary legal status the administration also sought to end as well. The decision put those immigrants at risk for deportation in and after September 2019. The Post's story caused an uproar as media outlets seized on another quote in which Trump allegedly referred to Haiti and African nations as S**thole countries. "Why are we having all these people from S**thole countries come here?" Trump reportedly asked. In a statement responding to the Post's story, the White House simply reiterated Trump's concern with the nation's immigration system, but it didn't deny the S**thole question. But Trump said Friday the Post inaccurately reported the language from that conversation. In response to Trump's tweet, Senator Dick Durbin, DL, who attended the Thursday meeting, said Friday that those quotes were accurate. "You've seen the comments in the press. I've not seen one of them that is inaccurate." To no surprise, the president started tweeting this morning, denying that he used those words. "It is not true," Durbin said, according to The Hill.